and Radio Sorter through till 1 o'clock today. Coming up in a moment or so, we'll be speaking to Craig Higgins, who goes under the guise of The Last Ghost here, local Trinette musician. He's releasing a new LP at the end of next week, EP at the end of next week, and he's coming out to have a wee chat about with us. But we'll open things up by playing one of the tracks for that said EP. It's called Extended Player 2, and this song I'm going to play for now is called The End of My Rope. And right after this, we'll have a wee chat with Craig about it. There we go, The Last Ghost there in the track, The End of My Rope, which comes from the new Extended Player 2 EP. And then Craig here to join me. Morning, Craig.
Morning.
Or afternoon, it is, in fact.
Oh, yeah, nice track. Thanks very much for having me on.
Thanks for coming in. And so I was just thinking earlier this morning, what I was going to say, I think it's about round about 25 years since I saw you playing your first guys in the band with other boys. It was a Rain and then Rainmaker.
I was actually thinking that when I was walking up here. You and I go way back in music.
Yeah, we've seen you playing many, many times with all your good pals, Craig and Alan and Doogie and whatnot, and obviously Burnsy and all these guys. But kind of over the years, you've done many, many things. A lot of original material back in the day, singing along with Alan and that and whatnot. And then you, of course, you had your wee sort of twosome act with him a few years ago, Last Man Frees
Last
All.
Last Man Frees All, yeah, aye.
So you released a few bits and pieces with him. So you've always kind of been involved in it for a long time, eh?
Aye, it's quite weird because I didn't really move very fast. So the last sort of thing that I probably put out EP wise was probably 1998 with Rainmaker, and then I didn't get back to doing a proper sort of solo EP to last year. So 21 years in between sort of official releases. So aye, I was just. I don't know, I've still done the covers bands and that for a bit of fun.
You did a lot of gigs for me over the years for all my charity different events, and you always came up and you always came up with a new name for the band. It was always the same guys, and you came up with a new
titles. The thing we liked the most, we had the same four people, but we never really used the same name twice. We had stuff like the Kings of Muscle Rock or
the Sex Hours.
I don't know where that came from. Usually we'd maybe be sitting having a drink before we went on and say, what are we going to be called tonight?
And you've done a variety of good cover versions and all these gigs. Ken, you picked your stuff well and entertained the crowd. So you've been at it for a long time. So the last year you released I think a sort of single to begin with, and then a sort of extended player one was a sort of a four tracker. Eh?
I put a lot of thought into the names of these, extended player one and extended player two. But it was maybe 2018 probably. I made a wee song on the keyboard just for a bit of fun, and I thought, that's actually alright, I'll stick that out. And that was the same thing. I needed a name. The last go stuck that on there because I needed a bit of artwork for it. Never put much thought behind it, and I enjoyed the process of recording it and finding out if I could do something more and if I could play instruments and all that sort of stuff, because I've never been a prolific musician or I can't play the sort of stuff that Alan, Craig, Chris, all these guys I've been in bands with can play, but I could probably do enough. And that got me just got me back into it again, and I thought, the EP is probably the next step, and that's what I did.
Right. So how does the process kind of start? Does it just start with a tune comes into your mind and you start working? Because it's quite a different process, isn't it? When you're with a band, you're all in a room together and you can start actually playing the tune and putting it together so you can hear it all getting played. It's a different process, eh?
I miss that because the band I was in, you mentioned before, like Alan or Craig would come in with a song, and they're far better writers. Well, I mean, they can write proper songs with choruses and all that stuff that I can't do. But this time it would be different. There's five tracks in this EP are really different from each other. One of them might have just been me at the guitar and something would come out, or another one like the one you played just now, I'd start with a loop. That's just a drum loop going round and round. Then I would add wee bits and pieces later on, and probably the last thing I would do, and sometimes in half an hour I would bash in some vocals and some words and stuff at the end. So it just depends. Each one comes out a wee bit different.
Right, so it's a different kind of process. So you've got this coming out next Friday, eh? So
13th of March. It's out on all these things that are Spotify and YouTube Music, Apple and all these kind of things. It didn't exist when you and I were talking back in the 90s and stuff.
It's so easy to access any music now. I think that's a big change in the music industry.
I was in it in the days when I was at it sort of full time, where you would make up tapes and you would distribute them by hand and stuff like that, or maybe later on CDs
and that.
And it's weird because the most interesting thing for me is the process. So after having a sort of 20-odd year break for new music, to come back and everything's changed, the internet and streaming and all this kind of stuff, I had to learn how that worked. And that's been just as interesting to me as actually making the music, just learning all that stuff.
Right, because it is a big platform. You find, like, I mean, you're doing quite a good thing, like these extended players, three, four song stuff like that, because music's kind of is becoming more instant now. That the days of like people releasing a classic album are virtually near the finish now. I think it's not really happening now. It's because they just make a song and release it, and it's
even just getting the. I think it costs a lot of money to make a really good sounding album. We were speaking just before I came on, my friend Douglas, who's on a band called Death Mountain, and he's got a launch tonight. Just yep. thought I'd throw it in while I was here in Edinburgh for this album. He maybe spend a year and a half or longer on it and get a decent producer and do all these things, and it sounds absolutely fantastic. It sounds brilliant, but the investment and time and everything else to do that now is really difficult for people who didn't have a record deal or aren't in the industry, and that's right, it isn't their job. So people struggle to do that now. So the days are, you're right, the days of the 50 minute amazing lush albums are kind of maybe going out the window a wee bit. It's a shame.
Yeah, mere instant. So I'm going to play another track. This was you got Craig and Alan involved in this track, didn't you?
Aye, this is something I was really buzzing for, because we'd never played together an actual recording since 1998, since Rainmaker, and this kind of came about by accident in a way. My friend Craig was down to play guitar on a different track, and I thought, well, while you're here, you can maybe chuck a bit of bass and guitar on this, which he did. And I thought, if I get Alan on this as well, then it's kind of the closest we'll get to a sort of Rainmaker reunion of sorts. And it was a sort of weird sounding song, and they put some really really good guitar. So generally on this EP, if you hear a couple of really blistering guitar solos, that's Douglas. that'll be Alan or Craig playing that rather than me.
So this comes out right. So you're going to do a wee bit of promotion. So as I say, folks, you can get on any of your streaming services. It's The Last Ghost that goes under, and it's Extended Player 2. But I say there's Extended Player 1 is available to stream now, and the other singles and that you've released. So I wish you all the very best with me, and
thank you very much.
It goes well. So, and one day we'll maybe see you playing them live if we can get some guys talked into it.
I'm too old now, right, for that. Aye.
just stick to sitting in the room and making the tunes.
I think so. Aye, that's probably it for me now.
Well, all the best with me, and I'm going to play a song. This is called What Do You Want, and this is The Last Ghost. Certainly different, Craig, eh?
Aye, I was just saying that just now. Aye, it's a wee bit different for the first
one. It's got a kind of maybe Nirvana sound to it, that, eh?
Aye, I think that's
sort of time in that, eh?
I think so. I think that's what I was thinking about, the time in Utero or something like that. So getting a couple of boys in it, as I mentioned, Craig and Alan, who could really bring it to life with some nice guitar, that was probably ready for the bucket, that one. And when they came and did that, I thought, this has got a new lease of life now, this is something different now. So I really liked it.
Definitely. So, well, good luck with it. As I said before, thanks very much for coming in.
Thanks very much.
And I'll play a wee bit of Cure now.